Hello and welcome to Better Geology. I'm Andrew Dunning, and that is the Willamette Valley. I'm here on Mary's Peak in Oregon's Coast Range, and it's the highest point in all of Oregon's Coast Range. From Mary's Peak, you can get a great vantage of this entire half of the state of Oregon, including most of the Willamette Valley, a large valley that dominates this part of the state. The Willamette Valley is named for the Willamette River, which flows down its middle, but the river itself is not nearly large enough to create this big of a valley. So what is powerful enough to create a valley that is the size the Willamette Valley is? The answer is that is a four-arc basin. Due to the Cascadia subduction zone, which is just offshore of Oregon's coast, there are many features on the land that reflect the subduction zone offshore. The Cascade Mountains, for example, are a magmatic arc, which result from the Juan de Fuca plate as it subducts underneath the North American plate, melting and creating volcanoes inland. Since the Willamette Valley is on the coastal or subduction zone side of the magmatic arc, it is called a four-arc basin. The force of the two plates colliding lifted up Oregon's Coast Range, which is a large anticline that stretches from the north to the south end of the state's coast. Since the Coast Range was uplifted into an anticline, it forced the Willamette Valley, a four-arc basin, downward in a syncline, which allowed the river and other sediments to fill it up to its current valley floor level. This has been Better Geology. I'm Andrew Dunning. Thank you for watching.